Welcome back. In a previous video, we saw how button flows and team flows are a great way to start to create useful flows for your organization or group. For this flow, let's build a SharePoint list where the marketing team for Contoso Flooring will store their Twitter posts and posting dates. And from there, we'll build a flow that'll auto-tweet the content for them. Let's go ahead and jump in. So the first thing we need to do is create a new SharePoint list. Let's go ahead and name it Contoso Tweets. And we don't need it in navigation. We'll go ahead and create. Now we can see it drops us right into our new list. By default, we're given one column with title. Let's go ahead and add another one with multiple lines of text and call it Tweet Content. This is where the things that you'll actually say in the tweet will go. Let's also add another column for date and time. So let's go ahead and click more. Let's check date and time. And now this is the tricky part. Make sure that at the bottom here, it says date and time format. You want it to say date and time. My first time doing this, I missed that. Caused me a whole boatload of trouble. Let's go ahead and click OK. We have to provide a name for our column, which is tweet date. Now we can hit OK. All right, our list is built. So now let's go ahead and build our flow. So let's go over to the Microsoft Flow site. Let's go to My Flows and then create from blank. Okay, so our trigger is going to be a SharePoint list, right? So the first thing we need to do is select SharePoint and when a new item is created. So because when we want our trigger to be that when a new row is added with tweet content, the flow checks for it automatically. So I'm going to go ahead and pick my SharePoint site. It's not going to load up for me, so I'll go ahead and type a piece of it. And we can see the list I set up earlier, Contoso Tweets. Okay, so that's it. Our trigger is done. Now let's add a new step and add an action and choose delay until. And so you'll see it lives under the schedule service and the action itself is called delay until. So we go ahead and pick that. And now what we're gonna do is, you can see how the dynamic content box popped itself out. We're gonna go ahead and use that. And let's go down to the bottom here and we can see title, tweet date, and tweet content are three columns from our list that we had just set up. So let's go ahead and use the dynamic content item of tweet date. So now what we have is when a new item is created in our SharePoint list, we will delay any action until the tweet date we set. So far, are you with me? Okay, good. So now let's add a final step, which will use the Twitter service. And we will choose the action post a tweet. So now what we're gonna do is open up dynamic content again and select tweet content. All right, so now if we look at it logically, what we see is when a new item is created in our SharePoint list, we will delay it until the tweet date we preset. And then once that date is met, we'll post a new tweet with the tweet column, the tweet content column that we set up previously. Now we just go ahead and click on create flow. And that's it. It's done. Thanks for watching this video. In our next video, we'll teach you how to add an approval flow to this process to make it so your whole team can power the company Twitter while still making sure all tweets are on brand and on voice for your company.